So Manoj Kumar from India. I had gone for the retreat arranged by Douglas Graham in Washington State in US last year. And I got completely convinced by the science that he was explaining in 80-10-10. And it transformed my health when I look back. And then I thought I should follow Doug on this and learn more. And then when I took a summer break with family to UK and talked to Doug, he said, why don't you time it with the Fruit Festival? Because you can enjoy that too and meet the similar community. So we planned it that way to come here. And what a thing I did. It's so refreshing to know that this breed is growing. I got the statistics. Apparently the Fruit Festival numbers in UK are increasing. This time it's nearing 200, which is phenomenal. So it's so wonderful to know. Back home in India, I work with farmers and plant organic fruit trees. So to know that the consumers for it is growing is spectacular. And here the main thing is, this is a fantastic initiation into 80-10-10. People, fruit is such a welcoming place to start the conversation. And then you get to slowly know the science. So the lectures are very good. I compliment the organizers for doing it so perfectly. It's chock-a-block, and it's improving, I'm told, every year. So I think they should even consider taking a bigger place, because next year it might even double. So great place to start, great new lifestyle beginning, and I think this would ensure that we have a healthier world. The people are all full of love and affection and caring. They're warm, open, and that's such a nice thing to know in this harsh world where people are so self-centered. To see the warmth here is so refreshing and so inspiring. The lectures are great. What I like is the lectures are the perfect initiation into the science of it. Otherwise, this would be considered as some mumbo jumbo. You know, I sometimes talk to the cabbie when coming here, he's like shocked, how can somebody live on just fruits, for instance. So there are a lot of people who might not, who would be confused with this. And I particularly was keen on the sessions, both which Doug is taking and his wife Rosie is taking, Rosalind is taking, which are introducing also about how to be practical in this otherwise mad world to have this different existence. By default, I'm an evangelist for organic biodynamic farming, because we feel we need to revive the soil and we need to introduce the fact that planet Earth has to be, Mother Earth has to be protected from the vagaries of chemicals that we do on our bodies and in the atmosphere. We need to protect it. So we have large-scale organic farming with small farmers. This is their livelihood program that we give as a support. So we give them the saplings, we give them the biodynamic fertilizers, and we do marketing. So currently we are the largest fruit grower in India, organic. So we have like 1 million mango trees, 9 million other fruit trees. We are the largest pomegranate grower. We grow chiku, we have custard apple, and these are spread across over 40,000 acres in 4 different pockets in India. Some of them in the mountains with the aborigines. So this is a combination of protecting the environment, giving support to farmers, and a lot of it for the organic ones to get a better price, I even export. So some of the fruits, who knows, next festival will be all the way from India, especially the ones you don't get. I'm all for a community or, you know, sourcing locally. But there are certain things that you don't get here, then you have to source it. We don't get sometimes stone fruits, we get it from abroad, so back in India. So you can't get jackfruit. So if there are non-seasonal, nutritious, good fruits, why not?